Clean your hands with soap and water or alcohol-based hand gel. Clean your work surface with soap and water or a disinfecting wipe. Cover your work surface with a clean cloth or towel. Assemble the supplies you need to check the placement of a feeding tube, flexible measuring tape, a syringe, pH strips, non-sterile gloves, a stethoscope, the type of water recommended for flushing the tube, and a clean container, such as a measuring cup. Put on the non-sterile gloves. Measure the external tube length. This measurement starts where the tube exits the nose and runs to the end of the feeding tube. Compare this measurement to the external tube length recorded at the time of insertion. Next, place one pH strip on your clean surface. Pull down on the plunger of the empty syringe to pull air into the syringe. Pull 1 to 3 milliliters of air into the syringe for infants and toddlers. For older children or adults, pull 3 to 5 milliliters of air into the syringe. Connect the syringe to the feeding port on the NG tube. Put the earpieces of the stethoscope in your ears and hold the other end of the stethoscope flat on the patient's stomach. Quickly push the syringe plunger to force the air into the tube. Listen through the stethoscope for a pop or a swoosh sound as air enters the stomach. If you do not hear the sound of air entering the stomach, follow the plan of care for replacing the tube. If you do hear the sound of air entering the stomach, pull back the syringe plunger to remove a small amount of stomach contents. Disconnect the syringe from the tube. Close the cap on the port. Gently push the syringe plunger to apply a drop of stomach contents onto the pH strip. Immediately compare the color of the pH strip to the color chart provided with the strips. The pH should be 5 or lower. If the pH is higher than 5, follow the plan of care for replacing the tube. Flush the tube with the prescribed amount of water. You may now begin using the feeding tube to deliver liquid food, water, or liquid medicine.